quite often that I hear about certain games not playing nicely with the Steam controller, that several fixes have been tried to no avail. Most commonly, these are games exclusively found on other platforms, though they can also be Steam purchased games. For those that watched my previous video, Steam purchased DOS games fall under this situation. When all else fails, there is one tool that will handle any situation, Global Steam Controller, or GloSC. What is this GloSC, you might be saying? As the official website describes it, it's a tool for using the Steam controller as a system-wide X input alongside a global overlay. Basically, it creates a fully featured config that doesn't have to be tied to a specific game. It's kind of like having a default config that never changes regardless of what application or game is running in the foreground. It accomplishes this by creating an invisible window that appears over everything else. Instead of letting Steam hook into a specific game, it hooks into this window instead. It acts as a mediator between Steam and everything else. Instead of letting Steam directly communicate to a game, GloSC acts as an interpreter, taking what Steam wants to do and translating it for the game. As for the Steam overlay, it simply gets displayed on that invisible window that GloSC runs in. Unlike when Steam is normally used, the game is never aware that anything unusual is happening at all. And GloSC's X input output is handled by Virtual Gamepad Emulator, or VGEM, which is better at appearing like a real Xbox controller than Steam's emulated X input. So let's try this out. First, we need to download and install GloSC. A link is in the description, as well as a personal mirror should the original link disappear one day. The installer also takes care of installing the aforementioned VGEM, so you don't need to worry about getting that separately. The install appears to stop at the finishing installation part, but let it be. It took roughly 30 seconds, but it eventually completed the installation successfully. Despite not showing any information, this is the part where VGEM is being installed. If this is the first time that GloSC is being launched, then it will perform a quick tutorial telling you what everything does. I'll be going over all these settings anyways though, for those who need the refresher. When we initially launch GloSC, we are presented with an empty box and a Create New button. Let's start by pressing Create New, which will expand the window and introduce all of the settings. Starting from the top, Name is simply used to differentiate your settings in the main window. It will also be used as a shortcut name that is added to Steam in a later step. Enable Overlay toggles whether you want the Steam overlay to appear when you run a game with GloSC. I don't see any reason to uncheck this since so many important features are tied to the overlay, but I'm sure there are some fringe cases where it is beneficial to disable it. Enable Virtual Controllers is required if you plan on using X input bindings through GloSC, especially in cases where a game doesn't play well with Steam's emulated X input, such as UWP games. Use Desktop Config is for instances where you want the Steam overlay but don't want to use a unique config. This is great for getting access to the Steam overlay in your OS since you have probably created a desktop config already. Launch Game runs a game or program alongside GloSC. If checked, you need to supply GloSC with the .exe file that you want to be launched. If the troublesome game is a UWP title, then you will need to press the UWP button rather than the ellipses. The argument box is for placing command line arguments for the .exe file. Most of the time you can leave this blank, but definitely leave this blank if you have no idea what command line arguments are. And finally, we have close shortcut when launched application closes. This simply closes GloSC when you quit the game that you launched in the launch game box. As you can read, this doesn't work with Uplay games, so leave this unchecked for that. So, let's see how all this actually works. Since UWP games are notorious for not working with the Steam controller, I'll be using Hydro Thunder Hurricane for this example. First, I'll enter the name of the game. Then I'll make sure the Enable Overlay and Enable Virtual Controllers are both enabled. Since I want to use a specific config for this game, I'll make sure that Use Desktop Config is disabled. I'll check Launch Game and click the UWP button. This brings up a unique window that shows all the Windows 10 apps. I'll double-click on Hydro Thunder Hurricane, and then I'll enable Close Shortcut when launched application closes so that GloSC closes when I quit Hydro Thunder. After all the settings are applied, hit the save button, and then hit add all to Steam, which will add a non-Steam shortcut for each setting that we created in GloSC, just Hydro Thunder for this example. Steam will need to restart to update the shortcut, so press yes at the next dialog box. When Steam boots up, we will see that the Steam list is updated with our new shortcut or shortcuts. We can create configs for these shortcuts just like any other game, and when we run them, they function as expected, except now they appear to have full Steam overlay and Steam input support, as well as X input support and Rumble support. GloSC works for Uplay games, Origin games, UWP, Windows Store games, and pretty much anything you can think of. It even works with programs. Here, I'll add HitFilm Express using hitfilmexpress.exe in the launch game box. When I launch it from Steam, I get full overlay support, including radial menus, which is great for swapping between tools or for placing undo, redo, save, and load. GloSC can also be launched without any accompanying software. This is great when you want that plug-and-play Xbox controller experience. Just create a setting with the launch game box unchecked and add that shortcut to Steam. Then create a config for that with the generic gamepad config and launch that before you launch any other game. And it also works well with our DOSBox situation from last video. Create a config for a specific game without the launch game box checked, run the shortcut, and then run the DOS game as usual. You'll have full Steam overlay and input support without messing with DOSBox files at all. GloSC isn't perfect though. Since the Steam overlay appears in a separate window, it has to be switched to in order to see the overlay. While GloSC does a good job at giving itself focus when the overlay is brought up, not every game is so willing to give up focus. UWP games fall into this category. Pressing the Steam button did indeed display the overlay on GloSC's window, but the game wouldn't give up focus. Alt-tabbing to GloSC works perfectly as a worker on those, so be sure to put that binding somewhere in your Steam cord config. GloSC is immensely powerful and is a tool that should be found in any Steam input user's toolbox. The ability to use Steam input with problematic games is invaluable, and the subsequent functions, Steam overlaying a desktop and a quasi plug-and-play experience, are icing on the cake. Also, remember that despite the application being called Global Steam Controller, it will work with any controller that is functioning through Steam input. So this benefits all PC controller users, regardless of which input device they prefer.